Booty hole. It's the sex show. Cute fancy up in the heat. I'm just looking anywhere, but I'm looking at myself. So y'all haven't seen us in a while. And that's good because you need to take a break from folks from time to time so that you don't get bored with them. Happy New Year!
What up, though? It's 2018 now. And it's the year of balance. It must be a balance.
Totally back at it. We said we're gonna make a video every day this year, regardless of what it is. So wish us luck. We've never done this. We've attempted several times. We always just say, you know, forget it and stop. Our videos are going to be clean. We're going to make, you know, censored videos. Because that's going to be worth our while to do this every day. You know, what we have to censor our videos. Or we won't make money from it.
Some might seem boring. Or we might be bleeped out.
Or we might be bleeped out. Whatever. You know, I've learned how to bleep out, but that don't mean I have time to do it all the time. So if y'all want to see us, y'all got to take us. Y'all take us. But we have some new things that we want to do. Our relationship segment, you know, we're going to give relationship advice once a week and help couples out and help couples find love.
Do we care if couples find love?
We do care that couples find love because love is very important to your health. If you don't have love in your life, you're not going to be happy.
Can you teach somebody how to love somebody?
Yes. You know, it already comes with you. You come with a loving spirit and heart. You were taught to hate. So you can teach people how to love again if they was taught to hate. You got to teach them how to love. Sometimes you got to coach people on things. That's what we're going to do. We're going to be our love coach, our love doctors. Y'all are love sick, and we're going to heal y'all. So I got a question on baby that I wanted to ask. And we're just going to give the his and her point of view on things. And I just been thinking about this because, you know, I'm writing a song and I'm so excited about it. And, you know, it's helping me. You know, I'm going to use these vlogs to help me overcome, you know, insecurities that I may have had in the past. And other people, too. Like, this is just a vlog to help. We're going to help couples from our experience, from our mishaps that we have had. So my question, baby, you know, how come men don't care about their asses? Like, how come y'all don't care if y'all got a big one or a flat one or a round one or whatever? Y'all just strut around. Y'all don't care. You don't even look at it. You don't even. I just wonder, like, women are so obsessed with it. Like, I'm obsessed with my ass. You know, I'm obsessed with other asses. Like, everyone's obsessed with an ass, but except men aren't obsessed with their own asses. They don't care at all. Like, it wouldn't matter to you if it wouldn't matter what kind you have. You probably don't even know what kind you have.
I don't know.
You don't know if it's round or flat or chunky or... I mean, you got one that you can wear football pants in and it would have like a little whoop with it. I mean, you look like you got an ass where you...
Athletic ass.
Yeah, it's athletic. It's high up. It look like you done done squats before. And you don't. I mean, I ain't never seen you do none. You told me that you do, though. You know, before we got together, you told me you did all kind of exercise that I never see you do.
I don't have to no more.
What?
That shit dead, man.
So, what do you mean? What do you mean not working out? Baby, what do you mean you're not working out? I thought we were... That's what I'm saying. You're not supposed to let yourself get old. That's the other question. Why do people let them say, I'm old, so forget it. Baby, I thought that we are working out. I thought we were getting our health back together.
Yeah, we are.
So you are working out. What do you mean I'm not working out anymore?
But I'm going to do stuff. I don't got to do squats.
So why is it that you have, if you've never done squats?
Because I'm special.
And squats are the exercise that they say you do if you want to get your butt lifted. How come yours is lifted and you haven't done no squats? And I've done lots of squats.
Because you wasn't born with no ass. Sorry.
What do you mean I wasn't born with it?
You wasn't born with no round ass.
So then that some people would take that as an insult. Like, I wasn't born
with...
It's because
they're not happy with themselves.
But I was born with a white girl butt. I post porn with a white girl, but I'm not white. So I'm making a song about it. But I'm so excited. I'm so excited about my song. And I've stuffed my ass. I've stuffed my ass.
Y'all women, go to lymphs, that's ridiculous. Like, y'all don't even stuff no more. Like, it used to be a booty bop, booty pop, whatever.
Now
like,
they just get
like
it.
Draws. You can just put it on and give you extra butt or whatever. Now, y'all done lost y'all's minds, man.
But I think in relationships, I think there's pressure from your mate at times to be someone that you're not. Because they see the people in the media, in the magazines, looking a certain way.
You told me to shave my beard off.
You did. I liked it without a beard. I like you with a beard, too.
You told me to shave it off.
You asked me if
I did.
You did. You asked me to take my weave out, and I did.
Yeah.
So what?
You asked me to shave my beard a long time ago, and I did. But now, you asked me to do it, and I didn't.
I asked you to do it.
But
if
I asked you to shave your
head off, you
wouldn't do it.
I didn't ask you to do nothing
so
to your beard.
I don't care.
You, why would you want me to look like you, baby?
I didn't say you. Why would you think you're going to look like me? How you going to look like me?
We have the same hairstyle.
You could get like a little flat top. You can get like a little box. Like a little Grace Jones off of... on Conan. A little Grace Jones off Conan. You could even like put some lines in it. You can do the little boy off Empire. Have lines and stuff on in it.
So,
color it.
So what do you think about what I have? What do you think about what I currently have?
I like it. I told you the other day, I told you I like it. Because you told me to shave my beard, and I said no.
When did I tell you to shave your beard?
But then if I told you to shave your hair, you would say no.
How long ago did I talk about your beard?
That was just looking at pictures when you were talking about.
Oh, your face. You'll never shave your face all off no more. You should shave it all off.
And I was like, nah.
Oh, you said nah? Oh, well.
I did say nah. Well, I still got a beard on here. I'm about to start talking like...
Why are you doing that, baby? We're trying to give advice.
I can't be in a relationship with somebody that you control.
Telling
one,
them what to
for
wear.
For one, that's stupid. Because when you do that, you're not even dealing with a person. The person should have a voice. A person should be able to make opinions and have it. An idea on what they want to do or some type of thought process in life. And like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you should only be able to compliment that person, man. That's it, man. You ain't supposed to be telling that person what to do, how to do stuff, what to look like, because that make you look stupid.
You say, I don't like, you know, makeup and weaves
and all of that fake stuff.
But you had it on when I met you?
Yeah.
Something wrong with me.
But I'm not even talking about you.
Oh.
We're talking.
You can't do that. If somebody do that, then something is wrong with you.
But that didn't happen, baby. What do you mean? If you say you don't like it, maybe you did like it, or you just like the person, or what do you do? If you feel like if you get with somebody and you feel like they have an insecurity, you try to help them, or do you try to change them?
Man, you gotta know there's an insecurity to that person, man. It might not be no insecurity to that person. It might just be regular life. So you can't just make it into an insecurity of that person.
So it's not an insecurity of people.
It's an opinion that you got of your own, and a preference that you got of your own. If you even bring that to the table, like, okay, well, guess what? I don't like makeup. That's your preference, and you just making it known now. Some people like stuff like loyalty and trust and shit. Like, they don't really care about preference as long as you come to the table with stuff that's irreplaceable, you know? Oh, that's an important thing. Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't start losing your looks or a nice person might decide to go looking for luck somewhere else.
I think that you should be looking for love. I mean, but I feel like the person that you get with should be, you should still wake up to them looking fine.
I don't think you should go looking for love. So you find a bunch of
love. Well, you may love supposed to find
you. Ain't so much as that. I think you should try to find yourself first. Because then you'll know what you like and what you want and what you don't like and what you don't want. And then you'll be able to be honest with yourself and another person.
Well, I'm saying if you are looking, you should be looking for love and not looking for looks.
You mean if you're looking, if you're single and you just out here.
If you're looking, you should be looking for love. You shouldn't be looking for someone for money or looks or for anything else. You should be looking for love. You said you're not supposed to be looking for love.
Well, because some people be looking for love and be in a quest for this. Happiness, and that's when you can fall into smoke and mirrors. Because some people will feed you that. They feed you everything you're looking for. Get you, throw a lock on you, and
you gotta look for love within yourself. If you love yourself and you know, then you know what love is. You always gotta do all the things for yourself that you could do, that you would do for somebody else.
Do whatever you wanna do.
You're supposed to love yourself, be confident in yourself. Take care of yourself. Always, and then that person that love is gonna love and feel that way about themselves will come finding you. Wasn't looking for each other, he wasn't looking for love. Your mustache is different, baby.
You cut that? Thinner.
Yeah.
It's thinner.
Yeah, your mustache is different. You cut that?
Thinner. Moved out.
The message today is to love thyself.
Love thyself.
And then love will find thyself.
Love thyself, and then, like, you know, don't worry about those things. Be more organic in life. Mm-hmm. Find out about yourself, because knowledge of self is the most important thing in life. Because you know, nobody gonna take care of you like you. So know the person you're taking care of. In and out. It's you. You gotta deal with you until it's over. So know you. Then you'll know your worth. Then you'll know what you'll put up with and what you won't put up with and what you're willing to do and how far you're willing to go, how far you're not willing to go, and what you like and what you don't like, what you, all of that stuff. Then you'll know what love is when it's in your face. Because a lot of times, we don't even know what it is.
And then we
fall for the smoke and mirrors.
And then you accept things. When you don't love yourself, you accept other people not loving you or treating you bad and mistreating you and, you know, not giving you love because you never had it. You didn't have it. You don't love yourself. So that's the first thing. Look at yourself in the mirror and say self.
Yep, and then when you do that, then you'll be a better person then, you know. If not, then, like, you know, don't nobody care for real, man. Just get out the way. Won't you just, like, if you unhappy and you negative and you always grouchy and stuff, why don't you just go away? Go home. Stay in your house.
Going to rehab.
I don't got pets. Barring our animals.
Well, no, we ain't got no pets. I don't got none of that. Personal emotional trainers. We do have them. We do. That's what a pet is.
That's different, though, but I don't even got those. Like, I try not to even have those. But they do sharpen you. But they're too much. They too time consuming. And they usually drama. Ugh.
Ah, baby, why you make that face? You said drama.
Be real. Be real, it'd be disgusting. They'd be
drama.
Can make you do the false numb spot face you got. That's a numb spot for you,
you stopped. You paused and did it and everything.